Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease Registry describes synthetic vitreous fibers, or SVFs, as man-made fibrous materials used for thermal and sound insulating purposes and to reinforce other building materials. They consist of inorganic materials that contain aluminum or calcium silicates and are made from rock or stone, clay, slag, or glass. The three traditional categories of synthetic vitreous fibers listed by the agency include glass fibers, such as fiberglass and glass wool, and continuous filament glass, mineral wool, which contains stone wool and slag wool, and refractory ceramic fibers, used to insulate furnaces and replacement of asbestos. SVFs can become airborne when materials containing them are disturbed, and the Occupational Safety and Health Administration states that many workers in the U.S. are exposed to synthetic mineral fibers in manufacturing and end-use applications. Workers who install or remove insulation, or who are involved in building maintenance or repair, are expected to have the highest levels of exposure to synthetic vitreous fibers, according to the Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease Registry. Exposure can also take place in the home when insulation materials containing the fibers are disturbed or installed during DIY projects. Regarding the health effects from exposure, ATSDR reports that when synthetic vitreous fibers are suspended in air, they can cause irritation of the eyes, nose, throat, and lungs. When these fibers contact the skin, they may also cause irritation. This is why personal protective equipment, engineering controls, and administrative actions should be utilized when dealing with SVFs. To protect workers, there are also published occupational exposure limits for synthetic mineral fibers from OSHA, NIOSH, and other state and professional organizations. Regarding cancer risks, the International Agency for Research on Cancer has determined that refractory ceramic fibers are possibly carcinogenic to humans because of their relatively high biopersistence and the findings of cancer in animals that repeatedly breathed in high levels of the fibers. However, insulation glass wool, continuous glass filament, rock wool, and slag wool are not classifiable as to their carcinogenicity to humans, according to OSHA. These are just a few things to know about synthetic vitreous fibers and potential exposure risks. To learn more about this or other industrial hygiene, indoor air quality, environmental health, or safety issues, please visit the website shown on the screen.
IAQ TV, the place to be.